Peace, peace. Some consciousness one. And the name of this video is going to be The Fall of the Conscious Community. Now, why I titled this The Fall of the Conscious Community? Because within the last 2 weeks, we have seen some recent events. The first event starting with the lecture not being, you know, properly formatted, in which the debate turned in a lecture from two different platforms. You know, that was the first problem. And, you know, and that problem, that should have never been a problem. Because, you know, you got a lot of dudes out here who are very greedy and just money orientated, as opposed to just trying to get the information out. You know, and, you know, these days you got to pay people like their way, no matter what you expect or what you think they are. You know, you going to be live casting it, plus you going to get a venue that holds 800 people. Then you got to consider, you know what I'm saying, the people who going to be presenting the information. Now, that was the first problem. Now, as you see, it's a problem between Umar Johnson and Sarah Sutton-Seven. Now, you know, I kind of seen this shit a long time ago, man. And like I said in some of my other videos, man, these niggas is starting to sound like street hustlers, man, or jokers who's not even conscious, man. Because, you know, look, man, I guess, like, you know what I'm saying, like, people beefing and people arguing or people shooting each other names, I guess that is what sells these days, man. But, you know, real people, you know what I'm saying, recognize real shit, and real people also recognize fake shit as well. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I don't see how Umar can just, like, come out and just, like, you know, call a man an albino. Like, come on, man. Like, we're going too far. We starting to really tag people because of, oh, if he light skin or if he dark skin, you know, crispy. You know, what the fuck is this shit about? Like, you know, how's we conscious and we, like, we judging our own people? How the fuck we gonna get together when we can't even agree on who's black and who we accepting as a black man? Umar Johnson called him an albino. Now, I don't even rock with Seti like that. But I damn sure I'm not with, you know what I'm saying, a light-skinned, dark-skinned thing, you know what I'm saying, because that's a whole nother problem. You know, we dealing with the white man, and we also now we got to deal with whether, oh, if you light skin, that means you're not black. No matter if, you know what I'm saying, the majority of these dark skinned niggas only fuck around with light skinned women. And that's the thing. Like, I'm not saying all of them do, but a large majority of dark skinned dudes try to mess with light skinned women. So, you know, I mean, they going back and forth, you know what I'm saying, they arguing about who is the biggest or who got the most following. Fuck all that shit about who got the most following. That's some kindergarten, basic, simple shit. You understand? It's nowhere in the world at this point in time. Y'all niggas been lecturing. Y'all niggas been dealing with conscious. You've been around numerous other conscious people. You've been dealing with, you know what I'm saying, you're dealing with a whole higher, supposedly, intellect than just the average person. You know, now the average person don't even want to be conscious because they see what this shit is about. You know, all you learn is about, or what happened 5,000 years ago, 10,000 years ago. But these days, we can't even fix our own self. We can't even come together and be brothers right now. And we already got a fucking one, we already got an enemy, and we already got a foot on our neck. And we sitting here beefing with each other, calling each other out our name and all this other foolishness and who's the best. And listen, if both of y'all are best, you know what I'm saying, both of y'all should rock out, then you shouldn't even be calling each other out. Because that causes other problems like we got now. You know what I'm saying? I'm so tired of this conscious community shit and all this beefing. It's always somebody going against one person. You know what I'm saying? Listen, man, y'all niggas need to come together and, like, and piece that shit up. Really, y'all niggas need to come together and piece that shit up, because, you know, I know Umar could be the bigger man, but Seti is an ignorant motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? And I see where Umar came from, though, You know what I'm saying? I'm not, like I said, I'm not on Seti's side at all, because Seti should have never even called him out. Like, if you wanted peace, you should have said, well, you know what? I'm considering that just for the peace, you know what I'm saying? Just to keep the peace among the people, man. All Seti want to act like is a thug, and the moment he had his moment to prove whether or not he was a thug or was it or not he was a real nigga, and he ran. He ran. He was sitting in the back seat of the car with file talking about they going to the store. Them niggas ran. You understand? And I'm not saying that they ran, but you know, I guess sometimes you gotta realize either you outnumbered or you can't win. You know what I'm saying? So Seti, like, you gotta humble yourself, man, which I can see you ain't never gonna humble yourself. No matter how many losses you take, you still gonna present yourself like you a thug. You know, you should never call yourself a general, man, if you as soft as cotton, man. You should never call yourself a general, man. You know what I'm saying? In that video, Zion Lex, you and Zion Lex got an altercation. We don't know what really happened. Well, we know something happened. And I'm not going to, I know Zion Lex, you know what I'm saying? He's not going to lie. You know what I'm saying? He said, if you really know what happened, you will not be calling Seti a general anymore. So, you know what I'm saying? I know that man that gets going to lie. Something happened and it didn't go in your favor. So, you know what I'm saying? You should humble yourself. You humble yourself, man. Maybe, you know what I'm saying? Maybe you can work. But like Umar said, you got a Napoleon complex, man. You know what I'm saying? And look, man, I don't know what the fuck going to become out of this shit. I'm so tired, like, even watching these niggas. A lot of times, I don't even want to watch these jokers, man, to even see what they got. Because of shit like this, man. And then Umar, he talking about, oh, he's the best. He's the number one speaker. He's the Christopher Wallace and the Jay-Z. That's some nigga shit, man. That I don't expect to hear that from a fucking psychiatrist. Or I really don't. I don't expect to hear that from a so-called scholar or somebody who's supposed to be, you know what I'm saying, who holds himself to such a high, you know what I'm saying, such a high regard or whatever. I don't expect to see this from a nigga like this. I really don't. I don't expect to see Umar acting like this. I expect that from Seti, because Seti's a little ignorant motherfucker. But I don't expect that from a psychiatrist and somebody who should already know how to really manipulate or play with people's minds. Because that's what he went to school for, psychiatry. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I mean, I don't know. You know, you got Polite getting locked up. Then, you know what I'm saying, some nigga saying that his wife might be locked up or whatever, or the Fed seized his money. You know, listen, if that happened, listen, I'm not hating on Polite. I'm glad to see just one of us make it. But I'm not glad to see one of us make it. And then when we make it, we look back at the people and say, them niggas is animals. Or them niggas, oh, they live around rats. Oh, they not smart enough to get. So you telling me, you is one person and you got millions of people living in the ghetto and they all fucked up and they all don't have something in common. You know what I'm saying? You know, how are you so special over millions of people? And you hold yourself such a high regard. You know, so, you know, you asking for donations and shit. Man, I wouldn't donate a damn thing to Brother Polite. You know what I'm saying? If you would have been humble and kept the love of the people, maybe brothers would have been willing to dish out a couple dollars to you to really help you. But you shitting on the people. And you shitting on the people. Niggas knew you shitting on the people when you was with the Kardashians. You know, so by you showing pictures of you doing that, then you're on the bus, like you grinding up against some girl. Nigga, you got three wives and you still acting like you ain't never had no pussy before? You know what I'm saying? You still act like you ain't never had no pussy before? Listen, bro. Listen, your best bet is to keep it moving. Stop posting video. Niggas ain't buying into your wizardry, man. Niggas know what you dealing with. Niggas been seeing you for years. Niggas know. Niggas seen your different faces you put on. One minute you good, Polite. One next minute you bad, Polite. The next minute you trying to make up for being bad, Polite, with this sophisticated wording. This shit ain't gonna work, man. It's not gonna work. I used to like Polite because he used to motivate me as far as being an entrepreneur and make, you know what I'm saying? He's definitely good at that. That's one thing, you know what I'm saying, as a black man, that something that I learned from Brother Polite. But, you know, showing money and all, listen, I would never show no stacks of money. If I had stacks of money, that shit gonna stay in the bank. You don't see motherfucking Bill Gates sitting on no sacks of money or acting like he never had nothing or act like a nigga. And that's just what you acting like. You acting like you ain't expect to get it. You ain't expect to get that money. You acting like, oh, you just got lucky by getting that money, because a nigga who knew he was going to get that wouldn't even be acting like that. So, you know, with that being said, man, I don't know what's up with the conscious community, man. I mean, I don't know how many people going to choose to really stay, you know what I'm saying, to be avid followers or, you know, to continue to watch, you know what I'm saying, videos. Like, you know, I remember at one point I used to watch a lot of videos just to get information, but a lot of that Afrocentric shit killed me, man. That comedic shit killed me, man. Because that comedic shit, you know, that just, they just claim that supreme over everything, over the Moors, over the Hebrew Israelites, over Nubians, over people who believe in, like, you know what I'm saying, that they was the natives of the Americas, like that, you know, that's the problem. And that's the problem, like niggas like the Amirah Squad, you know. So, you know, look, man, I don't know, man. I think I'm just going to get the conscious community a break, man. And hopefully, man, these niggas humble up, man. Because, look, I might as well continue to keep watching rap videos, because that's how these niggas act. These niggas act just like Lil Yachty and fucking, what's this other clown? Soulja Boy. That's what them niggas act like. Lil Yachty and Soulja Boy. Cussing each other out. Talking shit to each other. You know what I'm saying? Like, look, really. This, enough is enough, man. So, you know, with that being said, I'm out.